Good evening and welcome out inside the Lumpkin Center here on the campus of Columbus State University for today's opening game of the 2019-2020 season here for the Lady Cougars. We welcome all of y'all joining us here on Cougar Sports TV. I'm Corey Aldis. We're ready. It's basketball season. The Lady Cougars late to the party. Every other Peach Belt Conference team has already gotten their season underway. That's all right, slow and steady. We're ready to rock and roll here inside the Lumpkin Center with the Lady Cougars. New squad, new year, new coach, and a lot of new talent out there for CSU this season. But some returning talent that you're actually going to see this season that you saw last year. Out there are the two guards, Kayla Carter and Leasia Williamson. They'll be leading the way for the Lady Cougars. Dynamic duo of upperclassmen in the backcourt as Carter and Williamson, two of the best on this Lady Cougar squad. But Ebony Williams, Taya Gibson, and Kristalyn Boston, also familiar faces. They'll round out the starting five for CSU, and why not, let's have the tip go out of bounds to open up the 2019-2020 season. Here we go, we're underway. Lady Cougars will start with the ball. Albany State, the team that's come to town. It's the annual PBC SIAC Challenge, as Albany State and Fort Valley State will be the two teams that the Lady Cougars will take on. The other Peach Belt Conference representative, Georgia Southwestern, they'll be rolling into the Lumpkin Center tonight to take on Fort Valley State in their first game. Williams goes up top. KC, her first three off the mark, no good, as Gibson battles for the board. It falls to Kristalyn Boston. Boston, a welcome sight to see inside the starting lineup, a player that battled so many injuries last season as a sophomore. It's great to have her back, averaged 4 points, five boards last season for the Cougars, and a big presence down low for them. You see it right there with contact and the finish. Lady Cougars like to apply their pressure defense. It's what they're known for, and it's what they thrive off of. And here they are in the fast break, a 3v2. Bounce pass, Williamson, double bounce pass. Gibson can't finish, but she'll head to the line for two. This is a team that shares the rock so well. Not really any selfish players out there. They're all willing to pass it around, and it's something that we've noticed inside of practice over the course of this offseason, as the Lady Cougars have done such a good job at moving the ball around and looking for the open shot as Gibson misses the first free throw of the year. Coach Matt Hauser, he's the new coach down on the sideline. He'll be patrolling the sidelines for the Lady Cougars this season, the fourth head coach in CSU history, as Gibson's off the mark, no good. But Williams, oh, she can't finish the bunny right there. Coach Hauser, an assistant coach last year under who was then the head coach, Anita Howard. She's moved on over to Georgia Southern. Great spot to be. And we definitely wish her and her husband, Theo Howard, and Chris Strakers over there as well, one of the other former assistants for the Lady Cougars, as you see the layup go down low by Jamia Bowman. We'll obviously be following Georgia Southern and wish them well down there, but it's a new era here for the Lady Cougars under Coach Matt Hauser. Up top, Boston, over to Ebo. Ebo on the right wing, gets a screen, not normally known for taking threes off the mark there, no good. Ebony Williams, last season, didn't make a single three-pointer. Already firing from deep to open up this season. Here's Williamson, going coast to coast. Off the glass, no good. A little hard again on the layup attempt, but it's given right back to CSU, and a block down low. Ebony Williams had her layup rejected, gets the putback. Bowman was there initially, her first block of the season, but Ebo puts it, gets it over to Gibson, and the Lady Cougars up by two. Look at Boston going up strong defensively, and they say she saved it, but Gibson gives it right back, and that's gonna be an and one opportunity for Sierra Norman. It's a little bit of some sloppy play there by the Lady Cougars. Gibson's gonna go out. Kari Jernigan's gonna come in. Remember Jernigan last season for the Lady Cougars. Averaged just under 4 points and three boards last year. The now senior from Lilburn. It's That three-point play is completed there by the senior from Lincolnton, Georgia. Here's Williams, screen set by Jernigan, up top to Boston. Williamson has already missed a couple of shots down low. She gives that one to Boston, tried the wraparound pass, got deflected and taken away. Albany State, a team that has done really well at forcing turnovers in their first two games this season. 20 turnovers forced, an average of 20 turnovers forced so far to open up their campaign. And they take advantage of another one. On top, 7-4. LeAsia driving to the lane, left it short. Offensive rebound, no good. Lady Cougars have been missing a whole bunch of shots down low in the paint. You know, that's something that Coach Matt Hauser will preach and talk about. He's a guy all about finishing strong when you've got positioning down low inside the paint. Those are shots and layups, really, that you got to finish and take advantage of. Williams driving, 10-footer off glass, no good. Another miss for the Lady Cougars. Makes have been hard to come by early in this one for Columbus State. Now 2 of 8 from the field. Here's Wilson. Kick out, left wing three, way short there. Off the mark, no good was Jackson as she takes a shot then to her face. Jackson, one of the freshmen on this Golden Rams squad. Got a whole bunch of new faces out there that you'll see up and down this lineup. Despite that, 4 upperclassmen, though, in their starting lineup. Some returners and some people that we saw last season in this matchup. Remember, these two teams squared off in the PBC SIAC Challenge. CSU coming away with the 64-54 win, although they were down early in that one. Here's Dozier, no good. Another miss for CSU, but they'll maintain possession. Those that we've seen come off the bench so far for the Lady Cougars, including their starters, these are all returners. They're losing so much talent up and down the roster that CSU had last season. Obviously, Tatiana Wayne, the big loss for the Lady Cougars. Averaged just under 18 points a game. You remember her, she was an all-region player for the Lady Cougars, one of the best and most prolific scorers in CSU history. That's a nice move there by Ebo as she'll draw the foul. They also lost Tatum Jarvis, 8 points a game. She was 3rd on the team in scoring. They lose Naomi Holloway. So 4 of their top 5 scorers from last year no longer on the team. A lot of points to replace. LeAsia Williamson, the only one in that top 5 that's back out there. She averaged 13 points a game last year. There she is, firing from deep off the mark. Make it 2 of 11 now for CSU. Halfway through the first quarter, they trail by 3, 7-4. Open jumper there, no good by Smith. Boston to Williamson. Williamson driving. Over to Williams, pump fake. And LeAsia will reset the offense here for Columbus State. See Georgia Southwestern in the house. So they're making their way through the locker room. That shot off the mark, no good by Jernigan down low. Another miss inside the paint. Driving, it's Givens. Gets rejected there by Boston. See if the Lady Cougars can finally get one to go here on the drive by LeAsia Williamson. They're going to call a charge. It's a great play down low by Norman to get in position. Leveled off her feet and drew the charge, and that's going to take us to the media timeout in this first quarter. A bit of a struggle from the field. Just 2 of 12 are the Lady Cougars. They trail by 3 here on Cougar Sports TV.
Choosing the right college can be a challenge. Does it offer degrees suited to your career goals? Are emerging fields of study more your interest, like cybersecurity, gaming, or environmental science? What about extracurricular activities, such as campus life, study abroad, or honors? Are scholarships and financial assistance available? Columbus State University has always been one of the most affordable colleges in Georgia. Now it's also one of the fastest growing. When you ask the right questions, you'll find out why CSU should be.
There are over 480,000 college athletes. Only 2% will go pro. That means over 470,000 will not get a shoe contract. No autographs. No private jets. No fan clubs. No Hall of Fame inductions. Instead, they will walk away with something much more valuable.
A smile is the best thing you can wear. At Cook Dental Care, we have a smile for you. We believe in creating a dental experience for each patient that demonstrates kindness, professionalism, and knowledgeable service.
También tenemos un equipo bilingüe listo para
out of the media timeout, it's a 4-7 deficit for the Lady Cougars. Make it 4-9 off the layup down low from Smith, who's just checked in. Down low, it's Dozier getting the layup to go, breaking the miss streak for Columbus State. A much-needed bucket there for CSU. They were just one for their last 10. Finally getting one to go down. 9-6, the deficit. See if Columbus State can start to slow things down here and get back up on the scoreboard as they trail by three. 3:47 left here in the first. Lady Cougars trailing by three here in the first quarter. Just 2 points apiece. That's where all of their points have come from three different players. Here's Journey Smith, by the way, who's also checked into the game for CSU. So Williamson and Carter getting a break over on the bench for the Lady Cougars. Shot there, James was fouled. It's a silly foul there in the air as James was going up. That one's gonna go against Kari Jernigan. James, one of the more prolific scorers on this Albany State squad and really in the entire SIAC. One of the leaders for them, averaged 17 points a game so far this season. She averaged 12 points and 3.5 boards last year in the 25 starts that she had. At the line right now, 75% free throw shooter so far this season. Gets that one to go down. James with three, Norman with three, Bowman and Givens each with two. That rounds out the scoring for Albany State. Here's Journey Smith. First look that we get to see of her in this season. They swing it around, down low they go. Boston, good positioning, but the double team came. That's a great job defensively there by Albany State. Coming over there was Norman. Possession will stay with the Lady Cougars. Got to credit Albany State right now in their defense, especially down low in the paint. They've been making things real difficult for CSU. Norman, down low, knocked away there by Gibson. CSU trying to show their defense, although it's poked from behind. It will stay with the Lady Cougars. .258 left here in the first quarter. CSU has been trailing this entire time, really struggling from the field. 3 of 14 from the field. Just 21% to start. Here's Boston up top. Smith, left wing, drives, double team came. Lost the ball, it's still loose. Picked up by the Golden Rams, and here they come on the fast break. It's Milner. Milner still with it. Great defense by Smith, although it will fall directly to James. Down to 10 on the shot clock. It's Norman, already with three. Drives in, off glass, and gets the soft little touch by Sierra Norman. She's got 5 early points in this one. Back we go, trailing now by 7 are the Lady Cougars. It's Ebo, down low, Taya Gibson, trying to turn it there. Great defense again by Albany State as they force a jump ball, and this time possession arrow is going to go to the Golden Rams. Boy, down low inside the paint, nothing has been happening so far for CSU. Turnovers at four now for the Lady Cougars. Milner over to James. James met by Merlos, who, by the way, has just checked in, and a turnover there. Smith read the pass, drives in, rejected. They had a three-on-one fast break. I don't think Smith saw her other two players right behind her. Just a simple pass back would have been an easy layup. They'll still maintain possession. They leave Boston open, 18-footer no good. Offensive board, and the putback down low. Finally, another one going down. This time, the sophomore, Journey Smith. Averaged 2 points last season for the Lady Cougars. Started to pick up a couple of starts later on in the season. Had six starts for CSU. She's actually worked real well on her outside shot. Not known for it last season, if you were to look at percentages, shooting just 15% from behind the arc last year, but that's something she worked on this entire offseason, and it's showed up in the practices that we've been down to watch. Speaking of three-point shooting, the one with the rock right now is a unbelievable shooter, although she gets rejected. Needed a pump fake right there because Norman came flying in for the block and another layup for Albany State. The bounce pass and the pump fake are your friends if you're the Lady Cougars. Here's Smith, Gibson, Dozier, nice pass. Crystalyn Boston gets the easy lay-in off the assist from Arian Dozier. Mentioned the injuries that Boston battled through all of last season. Caused her to only get 14 games in with 11 starts. She was someone that CSU relied heavily upon her freshman campaign. You just thought she's just going to keep getting better and better, but it was a little bit of an up and down season, and obviously a lot of that had to do with the injuries and the shoulder inflammation that she was battling last season. But she's healthy and ready to roll this year. 15-10, Lady Cougars down by five. Final seconds here of the first. Driving, bounce pass, down low, layup no good. And that's going to take us to the end of the first quarter. A little bit ugly and some sloppy play. Lady Cougars struggling down low to make their layups. They shoot 5 for 18 from the field, 27% in the opening quarter. 15-10, CSU down by 5 after 1.
Insurance, financing, walk-ins, and new patients are always welcome.
Good morning.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
For your family's dental care, visit us at cookdentalcare.com or call 706-689-2905. Again, that number is 706-689-2905. I am Dr. Kathy Cook, and I'm the official dentist of CSU Athletics. At Cook Dental Care, we provide dental dentistry for the entire family.
Dr. Cook?
Yes.
You have a patient in room 3.
Okay, thank you.
I knew that there was an opportunity to have my college paid for if I was good enough to play baseball at that level. That was going to make a big difference in my family. D2 baseball gave me an opportunity to play at a high level and to get an education that's going to be valuable for me throughout the rest of my life. I chose to take my experience of being a student athlete and pursue that within my career and to get a master's degree. If I wouldn't have had a baseball scholarship, there'd be no chance that I'm doing what I'm doing today.
Fifteen to ten, the score. Lady Cougars down by five after one. It's Boston, Gibson, Merlos out there alongside Smith and Dozier. It's the five out there for CSU, and well, they're going to start the second quarter with a turnover. on the turnover there, and it's going to be a lay-in here for Arian Dozier. There's a double team by the Lady Cougars as they try to force a turnover in the backcourt, and they force Albany State into a timeout. It's a 30-second timeout, so we'll stay right here. Although they're going to make it into a media length one, so we'll just take a quick break. 15-12, CSU trails by three.
Universities are working every day to keep college sports safe, so you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
As Division II student athletes, we are committed to being our best.
Division II National SAC is proud to partner with the Sports Science Institute to play a role in the cardiac safety and health of student athletes.
Although many student-athletes with heart conditions live healthy, active lives, up to 10 NCAA student-athletes die each year of sudden cardiac death during athletic activities.
The facts are that immediate delivery of CPR and AED saves lives, so everyone should be CPR and AED trained. Please join us in this important initiative. Make it yours.
To 12, Albany State up by three. Early second quarter action here inside the Lumpkin Center as CSU starts to try to reset and get back into things. Down low, the bounce pass to Wilson. Wilson double team, Boston defending there. Ball loose, and she corrals the rebound. Into the front court, it's Smith over to Merlos. First look at a three from Merlos off the mark, no good. Taya Gibson, though, down low, gets fouled. She'll head to the free throw line. We mentioned Merlos and her three-point shooting. It's something that we'll see often throughout this season. The transfer from Warner University, originally from Barcelona, Spain. She made 73 threes over at Warner University, averaging just over 10 points per game. Gibson finally gets one to go down. 1-for-4 now from the free throw line. She's got 3 points. Slowly chipping away at the lead, trying to get back into this one as that ball is swung around. James down low. Here's Boston corralling another rebound. 4 points, 5 boards already for Boston. Merlos in the corner as that one deflected away. It'll stay with CSU. 5 of 19 from the field, although they haven't made a single three-pointer yet. 0 of 6 is CSU. Dozier to inbound. Up top, it's Boston. Dozier had positioning and said Boston will take it from the elbow. Tie game. Took a while, but the Lady Cougars have snuck their way back into this one. Shooting 30% now from the field. Here's James. Picked up there by Dozier into the corner. The freshman with it. Now it's the junior, Yolanda Givens. Wait, you'll remember Yolanda Givens if you're a local here to Columbus, Georgia, straight out of Columbus. Played in 25 games last season for Albany State. Averaged just under 3 points and 3 boards. They'll swing that one back around to Givens. Givens has it up top. Over she goes to James. Back to Givens. That ball being poked around, and a foul is eventually going to be whistled on the Lady Cougars. That's Dozier's first, team's first foul. And Milner is going to check into the game here for Albany State. He's on the ball right now. Taking that three-point attempt from the right wing. No good. Smith doing battle. Ball bouncing around. And it looks like a timeout was called there by the Lady Cougars. 30-second timeout for CSU. 15-15 our score. Shooting just 28% from the field. But CSU has found a way to tie this one up as they've started to force a few turnovers. After Albany State had gotten off to that fast start, with CSU turning the ball over six different times. The second chance points is what's been killing the Lady Cougars. 7 second chance points already for Albany State. And they've taken advantage of those turnovers. Same five coming back out there for the Lady Cougars. .722 left here in this second quarter before we get to our halftime break. Five different scores for Columbus State. Boston's the one that's leading the way. 6 points and five boards now. Tack on a couple of blocks as well as she's dominated down low defensively. Remember, we mentioned she just needed to get a little bit healthy, get back to her normal self. Here's Gibson. She can be a force down low. Looked like she traveled, though. Gibson takes an extra step. And another turnover, although the Lady Cougars force one right there. It's the pressure defense from Smith and the lay-in there by Dozier. Givens, double team comes in the backcourt. Gets that one over to Milner. Milner gets around the double. Swings that one into the right wing. Off the mark, no good. It's Norman. Here comes Dozier. Dozier pushing the pace. It's just one on three, though. Had that ball poked away and gets it back. Smith in the lane. Left it short. Alexis Smith, the sophomore from Greensboro, gets the board. She's a big player off the bench for Albany State. Lady Cougars finally in front, 17-15, a two-point advantage. It's been a nice second quarter for them. And another turnover for Albany State. Defense starting to kick it up to another level here for CSU. 6:18 left in the second. This Albany State team, a very solid squad inside the SIAC. Got a couple of divisions down there in the East and the West. They're in the East Division. They finished in second place last year. Everyone was trailing Benedict, a team that ran through the SIAC 15-0 in conference play. They ended up going 20-6 overall on the year. Smith will head to the free throw line here for the Lady Cougars. Just a 55% free throw shooter last season for them. Right now, CSU only shooting 50% in this game. Now, make it less, 3 of 7 now from the field. Smith's second attempt is good. Make it back up to 50%. 4 of 8 now from the line are the Lady Cougars. Williamson finally checking back in here for CSU. Had a rough start, 0-for-3 from the field. Did get a couple of free throws in for CSU. To the corner it goes. It's Norman. Nice pass. 15-footer is going to roll in. As Bowman gets it to go down. Bowman now with four. Bowman and James each have four. Norman has five. Gibson over to Williamson. Down low, Boston with positioning. Easy make. Chrysalyn Boston has had her way in the paint. 8 points, five boards, a couple of blocks, and 13 minutes of play. And another turnover forced. It's the Lady Cougar ball. Five turnovers now for Albany State. They've been piling up here in the second quarter. Three-point advantage for CSU. Williamson up top. Kayla Carter, by the way, she's also checked in, has it. A layup is good. Up and under, two defenders right through them. To the rack, Kayla Carter getting her first field goal of the season. That should be an over and back. It was another turnover. Alexandria James turning it over there. And they continue to pile on here for the Rams. Five-point advantage. Carter trying to split two defenders again. Bounces it over to Gibson. Gets rejected. And then she'll pick up the silly foul. It's good defense there by Jamia Bowman. Grabbing her first block of the season. Right now, Albany State just needs to find a way to get a shot off without turning the ball over. And a little careless as of late. Bounce pass down low. That's a good one. Just missed the bunny. It was Bowman. Make that you got to have. Averaging 6.5 points so far this season. Skip pass. Another one. It's Williamson for three. Got fouled. She'll head to the free throw line to try to get her third, fourth, and fifth points of the game. .430 left here. In the second quarter is Williamson. We'll head to the free throw line. 75% free throw shooter last season. She was one of the better free throw shooters in the entire Peach Belt Conference. Started to slow down just a little bit there as her percentage dipped towards the end of the season, but it was hovering over 80% for most of the season. First two go down. Ebo having a laugh as she started to move there on that second free throw, forgetting there was three. As Williamson, no good on the third one. Two out of three there for the junior from Greensboro. Here's Norman driving, wild shot off the mark. Back rims it. Gibson clears, up ahead, Williamson. They find Jernigan and she missed the pass. Went from easy layup to a turnover. Got a little excited there. She was all alone underneath the hoop. Take your eyes off the ball for a split second, and it bounces away. These are some of the simple things that, you know, Coach Hauser and the whole coaching staff will look at, try to get their team to clean up some plays that need to be made there. If you're the Lady Cougars. Driving, it's Givens. Double team, taken away. Kayla Carter snatched it right away from her. Up ahead, Ebo, bounce pass, down low. Gibson and the harm. Taya Gibson putting it in, giving her 5 points. And she'll head to the free throw line looking for point number six. Great play by CSU to push it up ahead. The offensive rebound and the putback. Ebo. Now Columbus State starting to roll. They're shooting 6 of 10 from the field here in the second quarter. 60%. Another turnover forced. This time it's Jernigan taking it away. Ebo layup. Rolls out. No good. And the foul will be called as Jernigan will head to the free throw line. Alexandria James, by the way, that's going to be her third foul. That's a huge call right there as the senior, the leading scorer on this Albany State squad, is going to have to hit the bench for the rest of the first half. Yay. 28-17 with 3:37 left here in this first half. Jernigan at the line. No good on the first. Jernigan just a 62% free throw shooter last season, and right now Columbus State has had their struggles from the line, 6 of 13. Well, back up to 50%. 7 of 14 from the free throw line of the Lady Cougars. They've opened up their biggest lead of the night, 29-17, up by 12. Almost forcing another turnover, they did. Offensive foul called there. It was Gibson drawing it. And it'll be on Kayla Milner. Gone from two turnovers to six, or to eight, excuse me, here in this second quarter. So they've had six turnovers. Bounce pass. Williamson gets it to go. Leasia, her first field goal. She's got four free throws that she's made. She's got 6 points now. This defense here by the Lady Cougars has been menacing. They haven't let anything easy come. Almost a block there, but a foul will be whistled as Albany State's Jackson will head to the free throw line. Gibson with two fouls. Just three team fouls, though, for CSU. Got another one to play with in the final 3:02 of this second quarter. Right now, Albany State over the limit with five fouls. CSU up 12, 3 minutes left. Here's Carter. Just checking into the game, by the way, is Toxiana Wilson. Williamson, a deep three. First three-pointer of the season. Lady Cougars finally get one to go down. They're one of eight from behind the arc. Of course, it's Williamson who hits it. 34% three-point shooter last season. Into the corner, Albany State trying to respond. In and out, no good on that one. It was Jackson. She'll get the ball back down low, though. 15-foot jumper off the mark. Jackson, the putback. The freshman from Atlanta working hard down low. Jackson with four. 34-21. Off a screen, it's Williamson. Shake and bake, broke some ankles, had that shot blocked. Oh boy, Milner hit the deck. In comes Journey Smith. Out goes Williamson. Final 2 minutes of the first half, 13-point advantage. Albany State breaks the press. A little jumper there, rolls in and out. Foul is going to be called. Loose ball foul, though, on the Lady Cougars. That one by Yolanda Faison. Again, another one of the freshmen for Albany State. You've got Faison, Jackson, Milner all getting some PT early in this one. 14 fouls for CSU, so both teams in the bonus. Shot there, hits back rim, no good by one of the freshmen, Milner. The putback, Norman can't get it. Here comes Carter. Carter off a screen. It's Ebo, 18-foot jumper. The putback by Journey Smith. Right place, right time, gets it to go. Sophomore from Covington, Georgia. Getting her fourth and fifth points of the game. We mentioned, by the way, Toxiana Wilson back out there for the Lady Cougars. That's a familiar name if you've been around these parts in the past couple of years. Toxiana Wilson, the local product from here in Columbus, Georgia. Remember, she originally came with Coach Anita Howard over from Livingston College. And here she is back in a Lady Cougar uniform. Oh, Boston rejects it down low. Here comes Ebo on the break all the way to the rack. Can't get it. Boston trying to grab the offensive board. And oh, they're going to call a foul on Boston. And over the back foul. And that should send Albany State to the free throw line. What a play defensively. Boston can't believe the foul was called on her. I think Ebo just took her steps just a little bit outside there, got caught in no man's land, and it made the layup a little difficult. First free throw up and in there for Jackson. Her first free throw attempt. She'll have one more, second one good as well. 4 for 4 now on the evening. She's got 6 points. Right behind Norman, those are the two leading the way for Albany State. Norman's got 7. Meanwhile, for Columbus State, it's Williamson and Boston, 9 and 8 points respectively. Top two scorers for the Lady Cougars. Under a minute to go. 13-point lead. Largest of the evening was 15 at 36-21. Here's Norman driving off glass, wild attempt, no good. Boston clears. About a 10-second differential between shot clock and game clock. And that one good from Chrysalyn Boston. She leads all scorers with 10 points now to go along with 6 boards and 3 blocks. Final seconds, a 15-point advantage for CSU. Pump fake there by Norman. Drives, double team comes. And layup off glass is good by Bowman. Down to 3 seconds. Lady Cougars got to put it up, and that one's just going to be deflected away. And will bring us to the halftime break. Things started a little slow for CSU. Only shot 28% from the field in the first half. How about that second quarter, though? 10 of 16 from the field. As Albany State finishes the first half with 8 turnovers, the CSU defense was getting after it in that second quarter. They outscore Albany State 26-12. That's going to take us to the halftime break, 38-25, a 13-point Lady Cougar lead. You're watching Cougar Sports TV. We'll be back, second half action coming up.
Choosing the right college can be a challenge. Does it offer degrees suited to your career goals? Are emerging fields of study more your interest, like cybersecurity, gaming, or environmental science? What about extracurricular activities, such as campus life, study abroad, or honors? Are scholarships and financial assistance available? Columbus State University has always been one of the most affordable colleges in Georgia. Now it's also one of the fastest growing. When you ask the right questions, you'll find out why CSU should be.
There are over 480,000 college athletes. Only 2% will go pro. That means over 470,000 will not get a shoe contract. No autographs. No private jets. No fan clubs. No Hall of Fame inductions. Instead, they will walk away with something much more valuable.
A smile is the best thing you can wear. At Cook Dental Care, we have a smile for you. We believe in creating a dental experience for each patient that demonstrates kindness, professionalism, and knowledgeable service.
También tenemos un equipo bilingüe listo para ayudarle y cuidarle.
Insurance, financing, walk-ins, and new patients are always welcome.
Good morning.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
For your family's dental care, visit us at cookdentalcare.com or call 706-689-2905. Again, that number is 706-689-2905. I am Dr. Kathy Cook, and I'm the official dentist of CSU Athletics. At Cook Dental Care, we provide dental dentistry for the entire family.
Dr. Cook?
Yes.
You have a patient in room 3.
Okay, thank you.
I knew that there was an opportunity to have my college paid for if I was good enough to play baseball at that level. That was going to make a big difference in my family. D2 baseball gave me an opportunity to play at a high level and to get an education that's going to be valuable for me throughout the rest of my life. I chose to take my experience of being a student athlete and pursue that within my career and to get a master's degree. If I wouldn't have had a baseball scholarship, there'd be no chance that I'm doing what I'm doing today.
Go!
Don't you worry, my child. Everything's gonna be just fine. Little darling, you keep on walking. Cause I ain't never gonna leave your side.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe, so you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
As Division II student athletes, we are committed to being our best.
Division II National SEC is proud to partner with the Sports Science Institute to play a role in the cardiac safety and health of student athletes.
Although many student-athletes with heart conditions live healthy, active lives, up to 10 NCAA student-athletes die each year of sudden cardiac death during athletic activities.
The facts are that immediate delivery of CPR and AED saves lives, so everyone should be CPR and AED trained. Please join us in this important initiative. Make it yours.
It's not about where you were born. It's not about your gender. Or the color of your skin. Or whether you're rich, poor, or in the middle. No matter what you play, if you have the skill and drive to succeed in school and in sports, we'll provide the opportunity.
The American dream to me as an immigrant means having the opportunities that my parents didn't have. Being the first one in my family to graduate, it meant everything my parents sacrificed for me to get to this point. It was paying off.
Estoy muy orgulloso de Michael por haberse graduado de colegio.
My path to a college degree would have been completely different had I not had a scholarship. It would just relieved a lot of the financial burden.
These are your teams, your players, your community of fans. This is where they play, where they practice, where you cheer. At every meet, every event, every game. Your community is passionate, dedicated, supportive. You know the tension of a close game and the thrill of the win. So while you're cheering, keep an eye out for anything out of the ordinary. If you see something suspicious, say something to local authorities.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
We can stop to make sure someone is okay.
Get in the way and disrupt the situation.
Notify an authority.
Or walk them home safely.
We can change the language around rape.
We can make campuses safer for our teammates, our friends, and our classmates.
We cannot be bystanders.
Taking action isn't always easy, but it's on us.
To intervene.
Because we can.
Learn more and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
Opportunity to me means doing the things that will make you a better future. I always dreamed of graduating from college. So being the first one in my family to graduate, it meant everything my parents sacrificed was paying off. Having an athletic scholarship for the University of Mount Olive was key for my success. But I had the opportunity to not only get an education, but be able to develop as an individual.
Being a champion takes more than talent, more than the perfect pass, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the spirit to always push harder, the ability to overcome any hurdle, and the fire to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
NCAA TeamWorks is how the NCAA, member schools, student athletes, and corporate champions and partners actively engage in outreach efforts where national championships are played. Through initiatives such as NCAA Community 101 service learning projects, disaster relief efforts, youth clinics, backpack and school supply donations, and support of Special Olympics and the Make-A-Wish Foundation, the NCAA and its partners work together to leave a lasting legacy in the community. For more information on NCAA TeamWorks, go to ncaa.com/teamworks.
My path to a college degree would have been completely different had I not run Division II cross country for the University of Mount Olive. Having an athletic and academic scholarship was key for my success. Our coaches were really helpful with balancing out my academics and athletics. I decided to attend graduate school because I wanted to become an athletic director. Receiving the postgraduate scholarship through the NCAA provided me with the flexibility to choose the school that I wanted. So now I know that I can accomplish any goal that I set for myself.
On and off the court, we're focused on creating lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. More college athletes are earning degrees than ever before, but we've still got work to do. That's why we're raising the bar for incoming freshmen, so they're prepared when they get to campus, and why teams can't play in championships unless they make the grade. Education matters, and putting academics first creates a pathway to a lifetime of opportunity.
A smile is the best thing you can wear. At Cook Dental Care, we have a smile for you. We believe in creating a dental experience for each patient that demonstrates kindness, professionalism, and knowledgeable service.
También tenemos un equipo bilingüe listo para ayudarle y cuidarle.
Insurance, financing, walk-ins, and new patients are always welcome.
Good morning.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
For your family's dental care, visit us at cookdentalcare.com or call 706-689-2905. Again, that number is 706-689-2905. I am Dr. Kathy Cook, and I'm the official dentist of CSU Athletics. At Cook Dental Care, we provide dental dentistry for the entire family.
Dr. Cook?
Yes.
You have a patient in room 3.
Okay, thank you.
While they're focused on success, we're focused on them. Because protecting college athletes doesn't only happen on the field. After the buzzer, it's about healthier student athletes. So we're reforming to meet their needs, investing in groundbreaking research, and changing the conversation around mental health. We're working hard to protect college athletes because prioritizing their well-being creates a pathway to a lifetime of opportunity. Across divisions, sports, championships, and schools for nearly 500,000 student athletes. College sports create lifelong opportunity, and that starts with education. We've raised the academic bar so more are earning degrees, creating healthier campuses by working with the nation's brightest minds, and making sure more have the chance to succeed and are supported on their journey. But beyond the numbers, it's about opportunity, and we're working to provide it for every student athlete.
The American dream to me as an immigrant means having the opportunities that my parents didn't have. Being the first one in my family to graduate, it meant everything my parents sacrificed for me to get to this point. It was paying off.
Estoy muy orgulloso de Michael por haberse graduado de colegio.
My path to a college degree would have been completely different had I not had a scholarship. It would just relieved a lot of the financial burden.
We can stop to make sure someone is okay.
Get in the way and disrupt the situation.
Notify an authority.
Or walk them home safely.
We can change the language around rape.
We can make campuses safer for our teammates, our friends, and our classmates.
We cannot be bystanders.
Taking action isn't always easy, but it's on us.
To intervene.
Because we can.
Learn more and take the pledge at itsonus.org.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship, found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours, the home of Division II college sports.
It's more than a whistle or a call. We're committed to giving college athletes a fair shot, on and off the field. Covering the full cost of attendance, because college costs go beyond tuition. Keeping dreams on track, regardless of performance or injury. And creating equal opportunities and inclusive environments. It's about respecting college athletes and prioritizing fairness to build a pathway to lifelong opportunity.
As a student athlete in college, I first got involved with the NCAA at the national level. It was through the Student Athlete Advisory Committee, SAC, gave me an opportunity to advocate on behalf of all student athletes to affect change and to make an impact. The NCAA is giving the student athlete a platform to voice their concerns and to be able to advocate for what's going to affect their well-being. The policies that are being put in place are speaking towards academics, they're speaking towards well-being, they're speaking towards fairness, creating a culture so that the student athletes have the best experiences possible.
Label me.
You know you want to.
Don't be shy.
You do it behind my back.
So say it to my face.
You don't know me.
You know what I am?
I'm a pitcher.
I'm a striker.
I'm a point guard.
I'm a linebacker.
I'm a setter.
Shortstop.
High jumper.
Wrestler.
Defender.
Goalie.
Student.
Welcome back here to the Lumpkin Center as we get second half action underway. A dominating second quarter there by Columbus State, outscoring Albany State 26-12, and they open up a 13-point advantage as we start the third quarter. We welcome all of y'all joining us here on Cougar Sports TV. We'll be here all season long inside the Lumpkin Center as you see Gibson go in for two. Turnovers were the story there in that second quarter as Columbus State took full advantage of some miscues from Albany State and opened up the big double-digit advantage. Again, another leak out, and this time it's Ebo going in for two. But Columbus State has taken full advantage here in the past couple of quarters against Albany State. Opening up a 17-point lead. This is their largest lead of the night. Here comes Leasia Williamson with it. Right to left, she'll be fouled. They're going to say it's on the ground, though. No free throws here for Williamson. Williamson and Boston, they were the two leading the way for CSU. Boston, what a first half she had. 10 points, 6 boards, 3 blocks. Shot 5 of 7 from the field. Williamson, by the way, 7 points, 3 boards, and 2 assists. Early substitution as Smith is going to come in for Wilson. 42-25 off the inbound. Boston will head to the line. It's a play call that Coach Hauser loves. A nice inbound play there. Gets two free throws upcoming for Boston. Now the thing that Columbus State needs to work on is finishing when they get to the line. Bit of a struggle there in that first half. 7 of 14 from the free throw line. This will be Boston's first attempts of the season. Can't get the first one to go. One more upcoming. And that one goes down. One out of two. Keeps the pace going for CSU. 50% from the line tonight. driving, wild drive there by James, yet she's going to draw the foul on Gibson, who can't believe it. James just got the ball, put her head down, and drove to the rack. She had a bit of a struggle in their loss against Valdosta State. Albany State was hanging in there against Valdosta before things really opened up against them, falling by 31. James shot just 4-15 from the field, although she did end up putting 14 points up on the scoreboard to go along with 6 rebounds as Williamson gets the scoop shot to drop. Albany State actually had a lead in the first quarter. Their other game was against West Florida. They had a lead against them 25-21 after the first. Well, they ended up getting outscored by 28 points in the second half. And West Florida stormed a comeback and came away with a 12-point win. Those are the two games so far. A nifty behind pass off the back there of Boston, who wasn't looking. But she missed the layup. Williamson traveled, though. An 0-2 record for Albany State, as they've been allowing opponents to shoot 46% from the field, while they've only put it in at a clip of 32%. That layup goes in down low. They're shooting just 29% in the early going in this one. Boston, back-to-back travels now for the Lady Cougars. Neither team shooting particularly well from behind the arc. We're a combined 1-for-16 between these two teams from distance. It's indicative of what we've seen so far, though, from Albany State and what we've seen in the past from the Lady Cougars. They really always kind of struggle from behind the arc. But Albany State starting the season shooting just 21% from deep. Last year, CSU, 26%. Not a real good deep shooting team. But they do have some talents out there that can hit it from deep on this roster, especially in the transfer Merlos. To the elbow, Dozier had it ripped away. Great defense right there. Coming across was James. James met by Ebo. Ebo, one of the better on-ball defenders on this entire squad. Did a good job of shutting James down there. This time, KC will switch on to her. Down low, layup good. Great vision. Coming from Alexandria James. Had just 3 assists coming into this one. Ebo is going to attempt another 3. It's a weird sight to see with Ebony Williams taking a couple of 3-pointers in the opening game of the season. Didn't hit a single one last year. Williamson off a screen, 18-foot jumper, nothing but net. She's now in the double figures. That puts 2 Lady Cougars in the double figures, both Williamson and Boston with 11. Almost forced a turnover there as the junior from Greensboro really getting after it. This time Carter comes up with the steal. Ebony Williams missed the layup. Offensive board, the putback can't go as well. 2 misses down low. That should have been makes for the Lady Cougars. The possession arrow will point to Albany State. Checking in, here's a 3-point shooter, Merlos. Although 0 of 3 from behind the arc to start this game. .621 left here in the third quarter. It's a 16-point advantage. CSU, by the way, will play again tomorrow as part of the PBC SIAC Challenge. It's Fort Valley State that Columbus State will square off against, and that's going to be a 10-second call. Just a little lackadaisical there and getting it across the midcourt line. Another Golden Rams turnover. You can see Coach Robert Skinner imploring his girls to focus just a little bit and play with a little more tempo and energy. Carter to the corner. It's Merlos. Quick fire. There's your 3 ball there. Val gets it to go down for CSU. Her first bucket as a Lady Cougar. Oh, tough bucket down low by Norman, driving with the hook in the right hand. Carter back to Boston, knocked away. Taken away eventually by Smith. Givens had it poked away, right back to CSU. 1v2, let's see what Williamson does. A Euro step into a block. And here comes Givens. It's Norman trying to get around Boston. Threw up a wild attempt. And now a 2-on-1 fast break. Ebony Williams trying to get around the defender there. Great job by Alexis Smith. The sophomore from Greensboro led the team in blocks last season with 31 of them. And now it's James trying to heat things up here for Albany State. James good on the jumper. She's got 6 points for Albany State. 5 minutes remaining here, 50 to 35. We'll take a break. You're watching Cougar Sports TV.
As Division II student athletes, we are committed to being our best.
Division II National SAC is proud to partner with the Sports Science Institute to play a role in the cardiac safety and health of student athletes.
Although many student athletes with heart conditions live healthy, active lives, up to 10 NCAA student athletes die each year of sudden cardiac death during athletic activities.
The facts are that immediate delivery of CPR and AED saves lives, so everyone should be CPR and AED trained. Please join us in this important initiative. Make it yours.
Lady Cougars up by 15. Journey Smith with it. By the way, Kari Jernigan is checked into the game and immediately gets whistled for an offensive foul. So it's Smith, Williamson, Merlos, Jernigan, and Boston. That's the five out there for the Lady Cougars. Givens with it up top. Jackson into the corner. The freshman Milner. Wilson is checked back in for Albany State. Lost the ball there and almost an and one there by Givens. She'll head to the free throw line for two. Givens will head to the free throw line here for two as Columbus State holds on to a 15-point lead. How about Albany State from the free throw line tonight? Perfect. They haven't missed. Lady Cougars have put up a whole bunch of misses. 8 of 16 from the free throw line of the Lady Cougars, but right now, Albany State, a perfect 9 for 9 at the line. Came into this game shooting just 64% in their first two games. It's another Lady Cougar turnover. That's going to be turnover number 13 of the night for CSU. It's led to 13 points off of turnovers. So Albany State has taken advantage. See if the defense can force another turnover, and they do. Williamson read it well, got bumped, and count it! That's how you get it done right there. If you're Williamson, 13 points now and a couple of steals. chance to complete the three-point play here. Free throws up and in. Here's Givens into the front court. Avoids the turnover there. Right wing three, hits the bottom of the net. There's James trying to heat up a little bit. That's her first three-point make of the night. She's got nine. Right behind Norman with 11. Almost a turnover there. Instead, it's Merlos. Buckets. There she is. Val draining a three for CSU. 56-40. She responds to James's shot. They're trying to go down low. A mismatch. And what a play defensively there. How about Toxiana Wilson coming over? Blindside there and grabs the block for CSU. Williamson, back rims it, put back is there. Defense leads the offense if you're Toxiana Wilson. Gets the block and gets the bucket for CSU. Quick fire three there is James. Now back-to-back threes for the senior. Boston, a deep two, left it short. Offensive board, though, by Smith, and they'll reset. Here's Wilson. Couldn't find Boston, missed her, but it falls to Williamson. No good on that attempt. Right back to Boston. Down low, double team comes. Still gets the hook shot up. No good. Back rim, and she'll be whistled for the loose ball foul. A lot of action happening down low for the Lady Cougars as they've been getting after it. Boston now with two. That's going to be the fourth team foul. So final 2 minutes of play, it's going to have Albany State inside the bonus. Another three-point bucket, and it's James again. That's three straight threes there for James. She's starting to try to power her team back into this one. 58-46. We'll take a quick timeout break. Cougar Sports TV.
Choosing the right college can be a challenge. Does it offer degrees suited to your career goals? Are emerging fields of study more your interest, like cybersecurity, gaming, or environmental science? What about extracurricular activities, such as campus life, study abroad, or honors? Are scholarships and financial assistance available? Columbus State University has always been one of the most affordable colleges in Georgia. Now it's also one of the fastest growing. When you ask the right questions, you'll find out why CSU should be.
There are over 480,000 college athletes. Only 2% will go pro. That means over 470,000 will not get a shoe contract. No autographs. No private jets. No fan clubs. No Hall of Fame inductions. Instead, they will walk away with something much more valuable.
A smile is the best thing you can wear. At Cook Dental Care, we have a smile for you. We believe in creating a dental experience for each patient that demonstrates kindness, professionalism, and knowledgeable service.
También tenemos un equipo bilingüe listo para ayudarle y cuidarle.
Insurance, financing, walk-ins, and new patients are always welcome.
Good morning.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
For your family's dental care, visit us at cookdentalcare.com or call 706-689-2905.
Welcome back inside the Lumpkin Center as Merlos, a quick fire three off the mark from the top of the key. No good. Guess who? Boston. She's been dominating the glass all night long. Crystalline Boston, another putback for CSU.
Sierra North,
Back to the line goes Columbus State and Leasia Williamson. She leads the way for CSU with 14 points. James, by the way, leads all scorers after those three made threes. She's got 15. By the way, that's a big personal foul there because that's going to be the fourth personal foul on Norman. The only other player in double figures scoring for Albany State. She's got 11. Norman has been doing it all for Albany State tonight. 11 points, 6 assists, 5 boards. But that fourth personal foul, that's going to be a big one. Two free throws upcoming here for Williamson. First one in and out, no good. Well, CSU had opened up a 17-point advantage, but James started really connecting from deep. Crawling Albany State back into this one. She hit three three-pointers against West Florida, just one in their loss against Valdosta. But you know she can light it up at any moment. There she is, driving to the rack, heading to the free throw line. This is what she does. That's her game, her style. Real good at driving to the rack, but also popping out for three. One of those do-it-all players for the Golden Rams. Quickly takes the first free throw up and good. A 75% free throw shooter on the year. Second one up and good as well. Two more points for James. Cuts the Cougar lead down to 13. Williamson off the mark, no good. They got to get back defensively, although that ball's going to trickle out and stay with CSU. Merlos, the one to inbound. It's Merlo, Smith, Dozier, Williamson, and Boston, the five out there for the Lady Cougars. Skip pass. They find the open shooter. It's Williamson in and out. That ball tipped over to Boston. Can't get the layup to go. The putback and heading to the free throw line is Journey Smith. How about the action that Journey Smith has been getting in on some of these offensive rebounds? She's got 6 rebounds now for the Lady Cougars. 4 of them have been offensive, by the way. She's been cleaning up on the glass. Boston, meanwhile, a double-double for CSU. Still got a quarter to play. We know what CSU is going to work on in their practices. How about those free throws? 10 for 19. They get 10 of 20. But it's saved right back to Smith. And now she can reset. Over to Ebo. Jumper in and out. Williams off the mark. Cleared by Bowman. And here comes James. Puts her head down. Kicks it out to the corner. Open look. Norman. They're playing her with those fouls. Pays off right there. Norman hits the corner three. Lead down to 10. Albany State's been chipping away. Lady Cougars, 1 for their last 9 from the field. It's a little 5-0 spurt here by Albany State. And they're going to call an offensive foul. They're an illegal screen on Ebony Williams. So another turnover for Columbus State. Under 10 seconds left. Driving, it's Norman. Into the corner, stepping up. Milner off the mark, no good. 2 seconds. Williamson can heave it. It's good if it goes. That'll take us to the end of the third quarter, 61-51. Albany State trying to creep back into this one. You're watching Cougar Sports TV.
Again, that number is 706-689-2905. I am Dr. Kathy Cook, and I'm the official dentist of CSU Athletics. At Cook Dental Care, we provide dental dentistry for the entire family.
Dr. Cook?
Yes.
You have a patient in room 3.
Okay, thank you.
I knew that there was an opportunity to have my college paid for if I was good enough to play baseball at that level. That was going to make a big difference in my family. D2 baseball gave me an opportunity to play at a high level and to get an education that's going to be valuable for me throughout the rest of my life. I chose to take my experience of being a student athlete and pursue that within my career and to get a master's degree. If I wouldn't have had a baseball scholarship, there'd be no chance that I'm doing what I'm doing today. Don't you worry, my child. Everything's gonna be just fine. Little darling, you keep on walking, 'cause I ain't never gonna leave your side.
As kids fall in love with sports, our universities are working every day to keep college sports safe, so you can watch them play with a little less worry and a little more joy.
Here we go, 10 minutes left inside the Lumpkin Center. Opening night for the Lady Cougars. 61-51, they've got a 10-point advantage over Albany State. The five out there for CSU, it's Williamson and Smith up top with Ebony Williams, Taya Gibson, and Crystalline Boston down low. Somehow gets that one to go. Tack on two more. Boston's got 15 points and 11 boards. But they give up an easy one on the other end to Smith. Smith now at 6-5. Columbus State had a 17-point advantage. Actually, they had a 19-point advantage in that third quarter. It was 50-31 with about just over 6 minutes left in the third. 50-31, and then all of a sudden, a big run there to end the third quarter by Albany State. Oh, what a crossover! Leasia Williamson to the rack. Little stutter step crossover there, left to right. Left her defender in the dust. She's already broken ankles once tonight. Boston, the rebound, up ahead. Journey Smith got caught up with James, and it's a turnover. Oh, Norman, another open look. This time she misses from the corner. Gibson's been picking up a couple of fouls. That's now her fourth foul, and I don't think she's agreed with a single one of them. The junior Givens checking back in here for Albany State. They trail by 12. By the way, Albany State, they made 4 three-pointers in that third quarter. They shot 4 of 5 from behind the arc. 3 of them coming from James. Albany State foul on number 11, Alexandria James. She has 4. James now has 4 fouls. She's going to check out. Norman, who also has 4 fouls, is going to check back in. They got to keep one of them on the court as they try to creep back into this one. So James will be the one on the bench with Norman back in. Williamson off a screen to Williams. And they'll reset. 12 on the shot clock. The drive, corner look. That's usually Smith's spot. Instead, off glass, no good, and they'll be able to reset. Give us a chance to talk about the new rule here in the NCAA as they reset the shot clock just to 20 anytime an offensive rebound happens, so you don't get the full shot clock anymore. No more all the way back to 30. I really like that. Speed up the pace of play just a tick. So they try to keep some of the stagnant play away from the game. Look at the passing. There's a corner look off the mark. Williamson, no good. Plymouth State has done such a good job on the offensive glass. How about this? 21 offensive rebounds for CSU tonight. 21. They've been doing work down low. It's Norman, met by Smith. Right now, Columbus State is sagged into a 2-3. Leaves Norman open in the corner, in and out. That's the hard thing with that 2-3 zone. You've got to find a man to box out. Columbus State didn't do it that time as Gibbons tipped that one over. And Boston will pick up the foul, and Smith will head to the free throw line. Boston will go out. Gary Jernigan will check back in. First free throw up and in for Smith. Smith with 7 points and 6 rebounds tonight. She's had a productive night coming off the bench. Had just 6 starts for Albany State last season, but she's come off the bench for the first 3 games this year. There she is, gets it right back. No good on that attempt, but the layup is up and in from Bowman. They've almost cut it down to single digits. 67-56, an 11-point Lady Cougar lead. They're trying to hang on here for the final 6.5 minutes. Gibson, there she is. What a pass and a find there by Ebony Williams. Foul on the ground there. That's already going to be the 13th foul, though, for CSU. Not even halfway through the fourth. Well, three players, I should say, with 4 personal fouls. Gibson, the one out there for CSU with 4. Here's Milner, down to 15 on the shot clock. Coach Skinner relaying a message. Milner's just going to fire from deep anyways. Missed it, offensive rebound. This time it's Bowman. And knocked away. Great defense there by Taya Gibson down low. They give her the pass up ahead. She goes behind the back and lost it. Well, she had the pass there if she wanted to do the behind-the-back pass, but she went behind the back to herself. And then it got knocked out of bounds. Should still be CSU ball, though. Williams will pass it in. Again, they get a great look off the inbound pass. That's happened twice now tonight on that back screen that's opening up the post player down low. It was Boston the first time. This time it's Jernigan who will head to the free throw line. No good on that first free throw attempt. One more to come. Second one rattles home for the Lady Cougars. Wide open down low. Miscommunication there for CSU. They lost complete track of Smith. And another turnover for CSU. Columbus State up by 12 with 5:28 left in this one. 19-point lead is dissipated just a bit. Albany State has gotten 1 bucket away from making it a single-digit deficit. There's a 2-point jumper there from Smith. And it's now down to a 10-point Lady Cougar lead. By the way, Smith all of a sudden in a double figures. That's three double figures now for the Golden Rams. James, Norman, and Smith. 17, 14, and 11 points each. Williams had that one blocked. No reset on the shot clock. Up top, it's Carter. Down to 13. Gets the screen from Dozier. Over to Boston. Down to 8 on the shot clock. Lady Cougars got to make a move. Ebo checked it. Down to 4. Driving. It's Dozier, and she'll get bailed out there as she'll head to the free throw line with 2 on the shot clock. It's a depressing foul there if you're Albany State after they had done so well. Oh, 2 seconds left. Free throws upcoming for Dozier. That should take us to our final media timeout. It will. 70-60. CSU up by 10.
As Division II student athletes, we are committed to being our best.
Division II National Sec is proud to partner with the Sports Science Institute to play a role in the cardiac safety and health of student athletes.
Although many student athletes with heart conditions live healthy, active lives, up to 10 NCAA student athletes die each year of sudden cardiac death during athletic activities.
The facts are that immediate delivery of CPR and AED saves lives, so everyone should be CPR and AED trained. Please join us in this important initiative. Make it yours.
It's not about where you were born. It's not about your gender. Color of your skin, or whether you're rich, poor, or in the middle. No matter what you play, if you have the skill and drive to succeed in school and in sports, we'll provide the opportunity.
The American dream to me as an immigrant means having the opportunity.
First free throw, no good from Dozier. It's been a big struggle from the free throw line for CSU. 11 for 24 now from the charity stripe. Make it 11 to 25. A mess for CSU at the line. Meanwhile, Albany State, though, 12 of 13 from the free throw line, 92%. By the way, James has checked back in. You just saw her with the ball. Smith out there right now, met by Boston. Into the corner, that's a two-pointer. Norman off the mark. Here comes Williamson, and she's pushing. A 3v1 if they take advantage. It's Carter to the rack for 2. James had to back away, couldn't pick up a foul there, and it allowed Carter to go in for 2. She's got 6. Trying to respond, quick shot, no good off the mark, and Smith again. She's been trying to match what Boston has done all night. Smith has come on late here for the Golden Rams. First free throw up and in. It continues for Albany State. .407 left. Albany State in the bonus the rest of the game. Smith no good on the second attempt. A missed free throw by Albany State. A rarity here tonight. Carter gets it across, met by Givens. Carter drives in all the way to the hole, but can't finish. Too strong off the glass. 3v2, here comes Givens, using a screen by Smith, and Boston just pokes it right over to Milner. They finally cut it down to a single-digit deficit, 72-63. That's gonna force Coach Hauser to take a quick timeout. He's not really happy with what he sees there. Well, the Lady Cougars, this is their first action this season. Remember last year they went 16-13, just 11-11 in conference play. It was something that was a bit out of the norm from what we've seen out of Columbus State in recent years. They went 19-10 the previous year. And then 31-2 back in 2016, we all recall the big Elite Eight run that they had after they were region champs in 2016. Coach Hauser looking to get his squad back on track this season as they try to finish in the upper half of the Peach Belt Conference. We'll get a chance to take a look at Georgia Southwestern tonight on the Peach Belt Conference rivals for the Lady Cougars. Georgia Southwestern will take on Fort Valley State. That's the second game that will happen here as part of the PBC SIAC Challenge. Swing pass over to Merlos. There was the pump fake, and can she get it to rattle home? Not quite. Oh, is she going to step into one right here? Merlos from distance. No good again. It's Boston, the offensive rebound. I thought she was about to take a third one right there. Instead, up and under. Well, three missed shots there by Merlos. Can't quite get it to go. And it's knocked away, though, by Boston and taken by Carter. Carter up ahead. Dozier goes around Givens back to Carter, and not really the best 2v1 there by CSU. Sometimes you just got to go left. Dozier tried to go back to her right. Just two in double figures right now for CSU. It's Williamson and Boston, but they've got real balanced scoring. How about up and down the roster right now? 10 different scorers for the Lady Cougars. Poked away again by Boston. Here comes one of the double-figure scorers, Williamson, all the way in. She's got 21, and she has been filling the role of Tatiana Wayne in a big way tonight. Poked away again by Boston. Look at the active hands by the post player. Now she's going to get the feed, and she didn't know what to do with it. Boston wasn't sure what to do with it that far away from the bucket. She had to laugh that one off as well. Tough break there for the junior. Oh, we'll forget about that play because she's had a phenomenal night. 15 points, 13 rebounds, 5 blocks. Here's Dozier showing off a little speed. And we'll head to the free throw line, fouled by James. They had taken away one of the fouls, by the way, on James a couple minutes ago, so she only has 3 fouls. Oh, well, no, she does have 5 fouls. They changed it back in the stat line, so the live stats had her only as 3 fouls. But it was correct. She had 4. That makes number 5, so she is done for the night. What a night, though, for James. 17 points, 4 steals, 3 boards, 2 assists. She tried to lead that comeback there in the third quarter when she made 3 consecutive threes. May as well keep the missed free throws going. Another one. One for two goes Dozier. Looks as though the Lady Cougars may hang on to this one, up by 12, just under 2 remaining. Right now, Albany State's got to work fast. There's a 3 from Milner. No good. Offensive board. Down low, it's Gibson defending. Trying to poke that one away, and finally Carter comes away with it, but she was out of bounds. Mentioned all the offensive rebounds by CSU, but all of a sudden the offensive rebounds have been starting to come from Albany State. They've got 12 now. That's a great inbound play. Reminiscent of what we saw from CSU on that back screen. Bowman with the easy lay-in. Carter for 3, got it. That's a 3. Kayla Carter, just a 20% three-point shooter last season. Her first attempt goes down the hatch tonight. 9 points for the senior. And a big 3 right there. Down low, she'll be whistled though for the foul. So Albany State will head to the line for 2 more free throws. Offensive rebounds, that's what is really going to stick out in the box score in this one. 24 in total for the Lady Cougars tonight. This is a team last season that surprisingly, usually they're a team that out-rebounds their opponents and does a great job at cleaning up the boards on the glass, but it was a bit of a struggle last year. I know that being a plus one in rebounding margin, it's hard to say that that's a big struggle, but for CSU and their standards, it is a little bit of a struggle because they're used to being plus five, six, seven on the rebounding margin. It was pretty even, though, last year. Another foul on Gibson, who just can't catch a break with the fouls that she's picked up tonight. That should be number five for Gibson, so Jernigan will have to come back in. Coach Matt Hauser looking to get his coaching career started off with a W. And it's about to be that way. First season as a head coach, first game as a head coach. Nothing better than picking up a win in your first game as a head coach. The assistant last year underneath Coach Anita Howard. He's got a wealth of coaching experience throughout his career so far, but finally at the helm of a squad. 80-69, it's an 11-point advantage here with 52 seconds left. It's a great way to start the season here for the Lady Cougars, but make sure you come right back here either inside the Lumpkin Center over the Cougar Sports TV tomorrow, as Columbus State will be back in action tomorrow afternoon. 3 p.m. tip-off time, they'll take on Fort Valley State in the second game of the PBC SIAC Challenge for the Lady Cougars. Also on deck tomorrow, the men's squad. They'll be here at home for CSU. And it will be great to see the men's team at home for the first time this season. They've been on the road to open up their first couple of games. They fell to Mount Olive in overtime last weekend. They're taking on Albany State tonight, though, by the way. That will start at 7:30. That's in Albany. So make sure to head over to csucougars.com. You can catch all the action by clicking on the live stats or live video links to watch our men's squad. Hopefully they'll be able to come away with a win tonight. They took down Barton 86-73 in the opener of the season, but they're 1-1 right now to start their year. Carter no good. Jernigan can't finish. Final 30 seconds of this one. The game's tomorrow, by the way. Both of them will be streamed. So the Lady Cougars will be right back here on Cougar Sports TV, as will the men's team. They'll be taking on Xavier LA, by the way. Their opponent tomorrow afternoon at 1 p.m. Men and women in action tomorrow. Big Saturday on deck. No better place than to be than right here inside the Lumpkin Center. We're watching on Cougar Sports TV. We've got all the action for you. Or you can also listen to Scott Miller over on WDAK. And he'll be on the call as well, down on the far sideline for the Cougars. It was the second quarter, a big one for CSU. That's where they busted this game open and got their lead. 26-12 is the differential, a 14-point advantage for CSU in that second quarter when they shot 62% from the field. Final seconds ticking away in this one. Couple more free throws upcoming before we put a wrap on this one. We'll grab an interview with Leasia Williamson and Crystalyn Boston in the post game, so make sure you head over to Cougar Sports TV as well as CSU Facebook.com/CSU Cougars for all the post game interviews and action. Talk with Coach Hauser as well, see how his first game went now that he's got the jitters out of the way. Lady Cougars made back-to-back free throws. It happened. Shot just 13 or 14 for 29 from the free throw line. And a steal there by the Lady Cougars, and they'll have a chance just to dribble out the clock. Well done there by Kayla Carter. 82-71, that's going to be the final score in this one as Columbus State. Well, Carter fires a three, and that one's no good as they'll finish with a win here tonight in their first game of the season. Big play coming down low from Chrysalyn Boston as she racked up a double-double and did well defensively as well. Picking up five blocks for the Lady Cougars. Williamson, meanwhile, led all scorers, 21 points to go along with 8 boards, 7 assists, and 4 steals for the junior. That's going to wrap things up for us here inside of the Lumpkin Center. A big-time win for CSU to open up their 2019-2020 campaign. For our cameraman, our statistician, for everyone here inside the Lumpkin Center, I'm Corey Aldis. Your final score, 82-71. Lady Cougars come away with the win. You're watching Cougar Sports TV. Thanks.